France gearbox there. Pedro Diniz, out in front.
Just a sec. Time's always tumble here like a fruit machine, as every lap you get a little bit braver.
Casalo is leading. Look at that. Oh, he slid onto the grass. He's been standing up in the seat of that car all weekend, really driving the wheels off it. Ever ones for tradition, the Ferraris will once again run in their world-famous scarlet livery.
Hang about.
Oh, he slid onto the grass. Mika Häkkinen has the lead.
The McLaren looks impressive. He's giving it full bananas. Mika Salo looks impressive today.
Jaguar Racing will be hoping for a flying start to their first Grand Prix campaign. They've certainly chosen experienced drivers, with last year's runner-up Eddie Irvine and Johnny Herbert. I'm sure Williams would be more than happy just to see Jenson Button get amongst the points, but the young Englishman may well have other ideas. For Charlo. I think he's lost this race, unless of course he can score back to win it. The last lap for Charlo. The now traditional split blue and green livery of Sauber returns again on a new car. This year the focus has been on aerodynamic improvements.
Just a sec.
Mika Salo slides onto the grass. With Jean Alesi's departure to Prost, Mika Salo's joined Pedro Diniz in the Sauber team for 2000. Diniz had a solid, if not inspiring, season for Sauber last year and must feel he can better his total of 3 points this time. That's an easy win for Charlo. He's won it, and there was no question about him winning it, except from his competitors.